Good morning, children. I am Asha, one of your social science teacher. Today, we are going to discuss the continuation of our third chapter. Do you know which is our third chapter? Yes, you are right. It is Major Landforms of the World. So let's start. In the previous class, you studied about different landforms. So today, we are going to discuss the another landforms which were on the earth. Is it clear? So the next is coastal plains, which is the next landform, coastal plains. Before studying about coastal plains, you should know what is a coast. What is a coast? Coast is the edge of the land where it meets the sea or ocean. Coast is the edge of the land where it meets the sea or ocean. Can you see this picture? Here, this is the coast. Coast is the edge of the land where it meets the sea or ocean. In another way, we can say that it is the border line between land and ocean. Is it clear? So, now we are going to learn about coastal plains. Coastal plain is a flat area of land located near... Coastal plain is a flat area of land located near a coast. This is a coast. So, these are the flat areas of land located near a coast. So, it is a coastal plain. Got it. So, coastal plain is a flat area of land located near a coast. Can you see this picture? These are the coastal lines of India. These are the coastal plains of India. This is the western side of India. So, this coastal plain is known as western coastal plain. In India, the coastal plains are divided into two. They are western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. Western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. Is it clear? So, there are two types of coastal plains in India. They are western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. This is the western side of India. That's why this coastal plains located here is known as western coastal plains. So, this is eastern coastal plains. Why? Because this is the eastern side of India. Is it clear? So, there are two types of coastal plains, western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. Both these coastal plains meet at Kanyakumari. Western coastal plains extends from Ran of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Do you know, children, where is Ran of Kutch? Ran of Kutch is in Gujarat. Here is Gujarat. So, western coastal plains extends from Ran of Kutch to here. Ran of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Ran of Kutch is a place in Gujarat and Kanyakumari is a place in Tamil Nadu. Got it? And eastern coastal plains extends from Ganga Brahmaputra Delta to Kanyakumari. Ganga Brahmaputra Delta to Kanyakumari. So, this is Ganga Brahmaputra Delta and here is Kanyakumari. Eastern coastal plains extends from Ganga Brahmaputra Delta to Kanyakumari. Both these coastal plains meet at Kanyakumari, which is the southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula. Got it. So, I am going to read this. The coastal plains are divided into western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. Two division of coastal plains are there. Western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. The western coastal plains extends from Gulf of Kutch in Gujarat to Kanyakumari. Gulf of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Gulf of Kutch is a place in Gujarat. And the eastern coastal plains extends from Ganga Brahmaputra Delta to Kanyakumari. This is Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. So it extends from Ganga Brahmaputra Delta to Kanyakumari. Got it. Both plains meet at Kanyakumari, so the southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula. So, this is Kanyakumari, southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula, where these two coastal plains meet. Then, do you know what is the climate of this coastal plains? The climate is hot and humid. What do you mean by humid? The amount of water vapor in the atmosphere will be high. Or in another way, we can say that the moisture content of the air will be high. Is it clear? So the climate of the coastal plains is hot and humid. Got it? Now we are going to learn the major ports of India. What is a port? Port is a place where ships are coming to load or unload people and cargo. Port is a place where ships are coming to load or unload people and cargo. Got it? So this is the picture of a port. There are so many ports in India, but you want to study only this much because this is mentioned in your textbook. Is it clear? So I'm going to read it. First is Paradip, Vishakhapatnam, Puducherry. So Paradip, Vishakhapatnam, Puducherry, Chennai, Mumbai and Kochi are some major ports of India. Is it clear? From this, Paradip, Vishakhapatnam, Puducherry, Paradip, Vishakhapatnam, Puducherry, Chennai, all these are located in eastern coastal plain. Where is it? Eastern coastal plain. And Mumbai and Kochi are located in western coastal plains. Is it clear? So I'm going to read the ports once again. Paradip in Orissa, Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, Puducherry in Tamil Nadu, Chennai in Tamil Nadu, Mumbai in Maharashtra and Kochi in Kerala. Is it clear? These are the important ports of India. Got it? The climatic conditions and soil of coastal plains are very good for cultivating some of the food items. For example, rice, sugarcane, oil seeds, coffee, spices, cashew nut and coconut are grown here very well. Is it clear? So the coastal plains we can cultivate these type of food items. Got it, children? Next landform is plateau. What is it? Plateau. Plateau is a flat area of land slightly higher than the land around it. So plateau is a flat area of land. It is a flat area of land slightly higher than the land around it. I'll tell you one example. In your classroom, there is a table for your teacher, right? That table is, a table has a flat surface and it is slightly higher than the ground. Just like us, a table, plateau is a, this is example for plateau. So plateau is a flat area of land which is slightly higher than the ground. Got it? So plateau is a flat area of land slightly higher than the land around it. In India, there is also a plateau region. It is known as Great Plateau of India. So it is known as Great Plateau of India. It extends from Northern Plains to Kanyakumari. In the previous class, you have studied about plains, right? So it extends from Northern Plains to Kanyakumari. So here is Northern Plains. It extends from the Great Plateau of India, extends from Northern Plain to Kanyakumari. Is it clear? Can you see this brown color line here? It is River Narmada. What is it? River Narmada. River Narmada divides the plateau region into two, which are Central Highlands and Deccan Plateau. Which are they? Central Highlands and Deccan Plateau. So the Great Plateau is divided into Central Highlands and Deccan Plateau. Is it clear? Do you know, children? Plateau are rich in minerals. What do you mean by minerals? Minerals are natural solid substances which are found on earth crust. So minerals are solid natural substances which found on earth crust. They are a combination of gemstones, metals, etc. Is it clear? Do you know which is the highest plateau in the world? It is Tibetan Plateau. Which is the highest plateau in the world? It is Tibetan Plateau. As it is the highest plateau in the world, it is known as Roof of the World. It is known as Roof of the World. Got it? Next landform is desert. What is it? Desert. Desert are dry places with little rainfall. Deserts are dry places with little rainfall. They are large areas of sand or rocks. They are large areas of sand or rocks with very few plants. We can see only a very few plants there. For example, cactus. Why? Because cactus require less amount of water. Also, it has the capacity to store water in their stems. So, like cactus, only a very few plant, very few plants can be seen in desert areas. Is it clear, children? Deserts have extreme temperature. If it is cold or it is hot, it will be extreme. Is it clear? Or for example, in summer season, the climate will be very hot and dry. The climate will be very hot and dry. And in winters, the days are cool and the nights are cooler. The days are cool and the nights are cooler. Is it clear? So, desert are dry places with little rainfall. There are two types of deserts. They are rocky deserts and sandy deserts. They are rocky deserts and sandy deserts. Two types of deserts are there, rocky deserts and sandy deserts. This is example for a rocky desert and this is a sandy desert. Do you know which is the largest desert in the world? It is Sahara Desert in Africa. It is Sahara Desert in Africa. Which is the largest desert in India? It is Thar Desert in Rajasthan. Thar Desert in Rajasthan. Got it? So the largest desert in the world is Sahara Desert in Africa and largest desert in India is Thar Desert in Rajasthan. Some other examples were Atacama Desert in South America, Kalahari Desert in South Africa, and Gobi Desert in China. These are some of the examples of deserts. Got it, children? Next landforms are island and peninsula. Next landforms are island and peninsula. An island is a landmass surrounded by water on all sides. Can you see this picture? Here is a landmass. Here is a landmass which is surrounded by water on all sides. This is a landmass which is surrounded by water on all sides. So this is example for an island. Is it clear? So island is a landmass surrounded by water on all sides. Island is a landmass surrounded by water on all sides. For example, Sri Lanka, Japan, Great Britain, Andaman Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep. These are the examples for islands. Can you see this picture? This is Sri Lanka. This is the southern part of India and this is Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is an example for island because it is a landmass which is surrounded by water on all sides. So Sri Lanka is an example for island. Is it clear, children? Next landform is peninsula. What is it? Peninsula. Peninsula is a landmass surrounded by water on Peninsula is a landmass surrounded by water on three sides and joined to land on the fourth side. This is a peninsula which is surrounded by water on three sides. These are the three sides. These three sides are surrounded by water and the fourth side is joined to land. The fourth side is joined to land. Peninsula is a landmass surrounded by water on three sides and joined to land on the fourth side. Got it? For example, southern part of India. Southern part of India. This is the southern part of India. The three sides of here is surrounded by water, and the fourth side is joined to land. So southern part of India is an example for peninsula. Got it? I repeat once again. The landmass surrounded by water on all sides is called island. Example Sri Lanka. The landmass surrounded by water on three sides and joined to land on the fourth side is known as peninsula. For example, southern part of India. Is it clear? The next landform is river. Large stream of water is called a river. A large stream of water is called a river. Do you know which is the longest river in the world? It is Nile River in Africa. It is Nile River in Africa. Rainwater and the snow melted from the high mountains forms small streams. These small streams flow down on the slopes. When these small streams join together to form a bigger stream, which is known as a river. Is it clear? So the small streams forms a bigger stream, which is called as a river. Can you see this picture? Here you can see the small streams, right? These small streams are known as tributaries. What is it? Tributaries. The small rivers that join the main river are called tributaries. Is it clear? So this is tributaries. This is River Amazon and it is the tributary of River Amazon. Is it clear, children? Rivers are of two types. They are perennial and non-perennial rivers. Perennial and non-perennial rivers. Let us learn about perennial rivers. Okay. Perennial rivers formed by melting of glaciers. What do you mean by glacier? Glaciers are large ice masses. Glaciers are large ice masses. So, the perennial rivers formed by melting of glaciers or large ice masses, therefore it having water throughout the year. So, the perennial rivers formed by melting of glaciers and have water throughout the year. For example, Ganga, Yamuna. Ganga and Yamuna are examples for perennial rivers. Next is non-perennial rivers. Non-perennial rivers are also called seasonal rivers. These are also called seasonal rivers. Non-perennial rivers are rain-fed rivers. When there is rain, there is water in that river. Is it clear? So these are rain-fed rivers and do not have water throughout the year. And do not have water throughout the year. So examples were Krishna and Kaveri. These are the examples for non-perennial rivers. Is it clear, children? Next landforms are delta and estuary. Delta and estuary. Got it? While the water flowing from the high mountains, the rivers bring alluvial soil with it. The rivers bring alluvial soil with it. These alluvial soil gets deposited on the these alluvial soils deposited on the banks of the rivers. Is it clear? So at the when the river enters into the before entering into the sea, the rivers are depositing the sediments on the banks of the river. Is it clear? So these sediments form a triangle shape. These sediments form a triangle shape because when the rivers, before entering into the sea, the rivers are divided and subdivided into small branches. So the sediments which were deposited here form a triangle shaped landmass. Form a triangle shaped landmass. Is it clear? These triangle shaped landmasses are known as delta. These triangle shaped landmasses are known as delta. Got it? So this is a delta. This is an example for a delta. The sediments deposited by the river form a triangle shaped landmass because of the division and the subdivision of the river. Is it clear? So this is known as a delta. For example, the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. The Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. Got it? I'm going to read it. The sediments deposited by the river form a triangle shaped mass called the delta. Is it clear? Next is estuary. What is it? Estuary. Sometimes the rivers did not form deltas. They directly enters into the sea without dividing themselves. So the wide area where the freshwater river enters into the sea is known as an estuary. It is known as an estuary. So the wide area of water where the freshwater river enters into the sea is known as an estuary. Is it clear, children? For example, Hooghly estuary. Hooghly is a river in India. Is it clear? Next landforms are strait and isthmus. It is pronounced as isthmus. T and H are silent here. T and H are silent here. So it is pronounced as isthmus. Is it clear? So strait is a narrow passage of water joining two large water bodies. Strait is a narrow passage of water joining two large water bodies. Can you see this picture? This is a large water body and this one is another large water body. So this is a narrow passage of water which is joining the two large water bodies. So this is an example for a strait. So strait is a passage of water joining two large water bodies. Is it clear, children? For example, Park Strait. This is the southern part of India and this is the another country, island. Is it clear? So Park Strait is in between India and Sri Lanka. It is in between India and Sri Lanka. So this is a narrow passage of water which is joining two large water bodies. Which are the two large water bodies? Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean. Is it clear? So the Park Strait joining two large water bodies such as Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean. So strait is a narrow passage of water joining two large water bodies. Is it clear? Next is isthmus. Isthmus is a narrow strip of land joining two large. Isthmus is a narrow strip of land joining two large land masses. So isthmus is a narrow strip of land. Can you see this picture? Here, this is isthmus. This is isthmus. Isthmus is a narrow strip of land joining two large land masses. Is it clear? For example, Isthmus of Panama and Isthmus of Suez. Isthmus of Panama and Isthmus of Suez. This is Isthmus of Panama, which is joining North America and South America. North America and South America. So Isthmus of Panama joining two large land masses which are North America and South America. From here it is easy to move to South America through this narrow passage. Right. Next is Isthmus of Suez. Isthmus of Suez is a narrow passage which is joining two landforms, that is Asia and Africa. This is Asia. This is Asia and this is Africa. So through this Isthmus of Suez, we can move from Asia to Africa or Africa to Asia. Is it clear? And one more thing is there, this is a natural isthmus and Suez is a man-made isthmus. It is man-made. Is it clear, children? Once again, a narrow passage of water joining two large water bodies is called a strait. For example, Park Strait. Next, a narrow strip of land joining two large land masses is called an isthmus. For example, Isthmus of Panama and Isthmus of Suez. Is it clear? Next landform is sea. What is it? Sea. A sea refers to a large body of water connected to an ocean. It is a large body of water connected to an ocean. So, sea is a part of ocean. But the speciality is it is close to the land. It is close to the land. These are oceans and this is sea. We called it a sea because it is close to the land. So, sea is a part of ocean which is close to the land. Is it clear, children? For example, the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal and Mediterranean Sea. For example, the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal and Mediterranean Sea. Got it? Now, we are going to do some exercise. For first time examination, the questions will be asked as MCQ. What is MCQ? MCQ means multiple choice questions. What is it? Multiple choice questions. So, this is the pattern of your questions. This is the pattern of your questions. Is it clear? So, I am going to read it. A long chain of mountains is called a dash. A long chain of mountains is called a dash. What is it? The options are peak, range, hill, plain. Which is the correct answer? Yes, you are right. It is range. A long chain of mountains is called a range. Second question. A dash is a flat area of land located near a coast. Options are coastal plains, plateau, mountain, peak. Which is the correct answer? Yes, it is coastal plain. A coastal plain is a flat area of land located near a coast. Third question. The dash is the largest desert in the world. Which is the largest desert in the world? Yes, you are correct. It is Sahara. The Sahara is the largest desert in the world. So, these are the model of questions. For the first time examination, the questions will be multiple choice questions. Is it clear, children? Hope all of you understood what we studied today. We will meet again with another chapter in another class. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you and have a nice day. Okay, bye.